get up tall because this one has long strings. So this puppet is made out of a funnel for her dress, a funnel for her head, a little muffin tin, and some egg beaters for her arms and legs. I knew those things could make a cake, but who knew that they could also make a puppet?
Puppets can be anything. You don't have to go buy one. We can make one. We should go try it. Hey, Bobo, did you find anything good to make a puppet out of? We can make puppets out of felt. We can make puppets out of cardboard.
Pipe cleaners and some googly eyes.
We can make puppets out of paper.
Oh, you have some spoons. Those would make great bodies.
We can make puppets out of clay.
We've got pom-poms. Are those the straws from lunch earlier?
Maybe we can make them out of spaghetti, but it might be a little bit messy.
We've got some string. We've got some little washers from the garage.
I'm looking for things that have a nice shape or a nice movement. I'm looking for colors and textures and shapes. These can all add to the personality of my puppet. I am cutting out some different features to try them out on my puppet. I'm not sure of the character I want yet, but I can change it up as I go. I'm going to use some glue and some sticky tape, maybe some paint and markers. I'm going to see what I can make out of these items I've found in my house. I'm going to ask my grown-ups before I just take this out of the kitchen and use it. I can add some eyes. That's something. But what if I add a mustache? I can give him arms. Oven Mac. He's a little bit zany. He looks like he's going to be a pretty loud guy. He doesn't look like he would be a very quiet guy. Not a sneaky guy. Add a row of ferocious teeth. Now I think he's starting to look like a little bit of a shark. I can add some fins. Oh yeah. Now he looks like a ferocious beast that lives under the sea. I can make this shark chomp. And if I keep cutting out paper and shapes, I can keep changing this character to make all kinds of different animals or people or vegetables. You can make whatever you want. How you doing, Bobo? Sometimes we just have to think about materials differently to bring them to life and give them personality. This envelope doesn't look very exciting when it's flat like this. But if I open it up and stick my hand inside, I can bend it over to create a little mouth. I can take the spoon, this plain old spoon, and this is already starting to come to life too. You could also use a handkerchief or a napkin or any kind of little scrap of fabric. And I cut a little hole in it to put her handle in, to give her a dress. And that would work. I could leave it like that if I wanted to, but if I hold my hand a certain way, I can turn my fingers into her arms. I can use a small rubber band for two hands with my thumb and my pinky. I can even cut out some little gloves out of paper. This spoon lady, a dress, and some hands, I totally changed her character. She's not just a spoon anymore. She could be a chef. She could be a witch. She could be kind of any character that I would like her to be. So, in my refrigerator, I saw this egg carton. And when I opened it up to get some eggs out, I realized the way it's attached on the side already would make a great mouth. So all I did was glue down a strip of paper on the top so I can slide my hand in. And with my thumb underneath, gripping it kind of tight, I can move my hand. He can be scary, he can be friendly, he can be hungry, he can be any kind of thing. I have this paper bag that I would usually put my lunch in to take to school. But I realized when it's folded, it's got this little bendy part if I stick my hand inside. I can give him a little bit of a face, and that's a start. But if I take some time with my scissors and my paper, and I cut out all kinds of shapes and designs, and I can turn them into something completely different.
Hey, Bobo. Hey, Bobo, check out this really cool puppet that I made. Oh my gosh, you made some puppets too?
I can't believe you already finished two puppets! I would have never thought to do something like that!
You know, Bobo, I can't wait to go on another adventure with you, but right now I am feeling inspired. I'm gonna go back to my workstation. That's such a good idea.
Such a good idea.
Okay.